Hello children, so last year you have studied the chapter carbon and its compounds. So some terms you have studied catenation, homologous series and class of compounds like alkanes, alkenes, alkynes. So this year you will be studying under chapter 12 organic chemistry some basic principles and techniques, so which is in the NCERT part 2. So what is organic chemistry? So it is the study of carbon compounds. Organic chemistry is study of carbon compounds. Do we study all the compounds of carbon? No. Some of the compounds we do not study. So except carbon is CO3-2, bicarbonates, some oxides of carbon, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, carbides, cyanides, and carbon element, allotropes of carbon element, that is diamond, graphite. So these are considered as inorganic compounds. Now we will compare this organic chemistry and inorganic chemistry. Organic chemistry, it is huge branch, it is very vast. Millions and millions of compounds are known today. What is the reason behind this? Why so many compounds are present? So this carbon atom, it has got a remarkable property, that is, it has got a unique property to combine with other carbon atoms by the covalent bond to form long chain of compound. So this carbon atom, it can combine with other carbon atoms by this covalent bond to form long chain of compounds. So this covalent bond is represented by dash. So you know covalent bond is formed by sharing pair of electrons. So this carbon atom, it can also form ring structures. It can also form ring structures. See the lines where it joins, these are nothing but carbon atoms bonded by covalent bond. It can also form branched structures. So here it can also form branched structures. Now can you tell me this unique property of carbon is called as? So last year you have studied this. So this is called as catenation. This is called as catenation. See, this carbon, not only it combines with other carbon atoms, it also combines with carbon atom, it also combines with hydrogen, it also combines with nitrogen, it also combines with oxygen, it can also combine with sulfur. See, carbon covalently bonded with the sulfur and similarly with the phosphorus. So now how will you define this catenation? Definition of catenation, it is the ability of an element to combine with large number of its own atoms by covalent bonds to form long chain compounds. So now we shall study the introduction. See, these organic compounds, they are important to support life on earth. Complex molecules like DNA, which bears our genetic information, deoxyribose, nucleic acid, then proteins. So proteins are made up of amino acids. Carbohydrates. So sugar, they are carbohydrates. Starch, sugar, they are carbohydrates. So, and essential compounds present in blood, skin, muscles, they are nothing but organic compounds. These organic compounds, they also appear in fuel. So kerosene, petroleum, they are fuels, they are hydrocarbons. In fuels, polymers, so plastic, that is a polymer. Then dyes means color. Color is added to food, to the textiles, that is to the cloth. Dyes and medicines. So organic, these fuel, polymers, dyes, medicine, they are nothing but organic. So this organic chemistry is 200 years old. In the 17th century, these scientists, they distinguished organic compounds and inorganic compounds based on the sources. Compounds obtained from the nature, that is from the plants and animals, they were called as organic compounds. So compounds which are obtained from plants and animals, they were called as organic compounds. And those compounds which were obtained from minerals, minerals, they were called as inorganic compounds. So based on the sources from which we are obtaining, they were. So in this way, organic compounds and inorganic compounds, they were distinguished based on the sources. Swedish chemist, that is Berzelius, he proposed vital force theory. So according to him, this vital force, it is responsible for the formation of organic compounds. So according to this vital force theory, the organic compounds, it can be obtained only from the nature and cannot be synthesized. That is, man cannot prepare it. But this theory, vital force theory, it got rejected in 1828. So in this year, scientist Wöhler, he was the first scientist to synthesize the organic compound, that is urea, from an inorganic compound, ammonium cyanate, in the laboratory. Ammonium cyanate, NH4CNO, ammonium cyanate, on heating, so urea is obtained. NH2CO, NH2. So this urea is organic compound. Ammonium cyanate is inorganic compound. So later on, scientist Kolbeck, he synthesized acetic acid. And scientist Berthelot, he synthesized methane. From the synthesis of urea, acetic acid and methane, it proved that organic compounds, they can be synthesized in the laboratory from inorganic compounds.
Scientist Burgess, he proposed vital force theory. According to this theory, organic compounds, it cannot be synthesized in the laboratory from inorganic compounds due to the absence of vital force. Organic compounds, it can be obtained only from the nature, that is, from plants and animals. So, he is the father of organic chemistry. Scientist Wöhler, he was the first person to synthesize the organic compound urea from inorganic compound ammonium cyanate in the laboratory. So, urea is component of urine.
So, now we shall study tetravalence of carbon, on shapes of carbon compounds. See, carbon, atomic number is 6, atomic mass is 12. So, the electronic configuration of this carbon atom is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So, now I show the pinning of these two electrons in the orbitals. So, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2px1, 2py1 and 2pzz. It follows Hund's rule, isn't it? So, now, so the outermost shell is shell number 2, right? Now, valence electrons are nothing but the number of electrons in the outermost orbit, or we say valence shell. So, 2 plus 1 plus 1, it is 4. So, valency of carbon is 4. So, we say carbon is tetravalent. This carbon, it can form 4 covalent bonds. Carbon is tetravalent. That's why it can form 4 covalent bonds with the atoms. This covalent bond, it may be sigma bond or it may be pi bond. So, you know, you have studied under the chemical bonding chapter, sigma bond, it is formed by axial overlapping of the orbitals, and pi bond, it is formed by sideways overlapping of the orbitals. Now, based on the type of the bonds, based on the type of the bonds attached to the carbon atom, we can tell the hybridization of the carbon atom. So, the type of the bond, it determines the hybridization of the carbon atom. The type of the bond, it determines what? It determines the hybridization of this carbon atom. Suppose if this carbon atom, it is attached to 4 number of sigma bonds. It is attached to 4 number of sigma bonds. Then that carbon atom is sp3 hybridized carbon atom. So to give you an example, methane, CH4, isn't it? Methane. So here, in this methane, all the 4 are sigma bonds, no pi bond. So this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. If the carbon atom, if it has got 1 pi bond and 3 sigma bond and 1 pi bond, then the hybridization of the carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. So, example, ethene, CH2, double bond, CH2. So, this is ethene. See here, this carbon atom is attached to
how many sigma bonds here? So carbon and hydrogen, the bond formed is sigma bond. So 1, 2 and this carbon to carbon. So this is the third sigma bond. So 3 sigma bond and this carbon to carbon, this is pi bond. So 1 pi bond. So now this carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. Similarly this also, right? It is sp2 hybridized. If the carbon atom is attached to 2 sigma bonds and 2 pi bonds, then the hybridization of carbon atom is sp. So the example is ethyne, or common name is acetylene. So CH triple bond CH. Carbon to hydrogen, it is sigma bond. Carbon to carbon, it is sigma bond. So 2 sigma bonds, and here these 2 are pi bonds. Right? So this carbon atom is sp hybridized. Even this carbon atom is also sp hybridized.
Refer this diagram for the number of bonds attached to the carbon atom, number of sigma bonds attached to the carbon atom, and the number of pi bonds, hybridization of the carbon atom in the molecule, bond angle, and the geometry of the molecule for methane, ethene, and ethyne. In methane, 4 sigma bonds and no pi bonds. The carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. The bond angle hydrogen carbon hydrogen is 109.5 degree and the geometry is tetrahedral. In case of ethene, 3 sigma bonds are attached to single carbon atom. So 2 carbon hydrogen bonds and 1 carbon carbon bond. And the number of pi bonds is 1. Carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. The bond angle is 120 degree. And the geometry is trigonal planar. In ethyne, 2 sigma bonds, that is carbon hydrogen and carbon carbon on each carbon atom. And 2 pi bonds. The hybridization of carbon atom is sp. The bond angle hydrogen carbon hydrogen is 180 degree and the geometry of the molecule is linear.
The percentage of s character in the hybrid orbitals. So what is hybrid orbitals? Hybrid orbitals, how they are formed? So when the atomic orbitals of slightly different energy, they combine to form this hybrid orbitals. All the hybrid orbitals, they have got same energy, even the shape is also same, isn't it? Now here, so in sp3 hybrid orbitals, s character is 25%. So how it is obtained is 25%? Total orbitals formed is 1 plus 3 is 4. So s, 1 part. So 1 by 4 into 100 is 25%. In sp2 hybrid orbital, the percentage of s character is 33.33%. So how many orbitals, hybrid orbitals here? 1 plus 2, 3 hybrid orbitals. So among that, 1 part is s. So 1 by 3 into 100, 33.33%. And in sp hybrid orbital, how many hybrid orbitals are formed? 1 plus 1, 2 sp hybrid orbitals are formed. Among that, 1 part is s character. So 1 by 2 into 100 is 50%. So how are we going to relate this percentage of s character in the hybrid orbitals and electronegativity? So higher the s character of the hybrid orbitals, higher is the electronegativity. So higher is the percentage of s character in hybrid orbitals, HOR, right? So higher is the electronegativity. Higher is electronegativity. negativity. Electronegativity is, it is the ability of an element to attract shared electrons. So here, among these hybrid orbitals, these three hybrid orbitals, which has got maximum s character? So 50% sp orbital has, sp hybrid orbital has got high s character, isn't it? So the electronegativity is very high. Now this hybridization, it influences bond length and bond enthalpy. So bond enthalpy is nothing but strength of bond. Right? Amount of energy required to dissociate those one mole of bonds is bond enthalpy. So if the hybrid orbital has got higher electronegativity, if this hybrid orbital, if it has got high electronegativity, EnI, right? So what will happen to the bond length? Bond length will be shorter. So shorter is the bond length. Bond length is short. If the bond length is short, so you require more energy to break the bond between the atoms. Means bond enthalpy is high. So bond enthalpy is high. So higher the electronegativity of a hybrid orbitals, shorter is the bond length and higher is the bond enthalpy.
Refer this table for the percentage of s character for sp3, sp2 and sp hybrid orbitals, bond length and bond energy of carbon-carbon bonds. The percentage of s character is 25% for sp3 hybrid orbitals. So example, methane, the carbon-carbon single bond is 154 picometer and its bond energy is 347 kilojoule per mole. The percentage of s character in sp2 hybrid orbitals is 33.33%. Example, ethene molecule. So the carbon-carbon double bond is 134 picometer and its bond energy is 614 kilojoule per mole. And in case of sp hybrid orbitals, the percentage of s character is 50%. The bond, example, ethyne, the bond length carbon-carbon triple bond is 131 picometer and its bond energy is 839 kilojoule per mole. So here we can see that the percentage of s character is maximum for sp hybrid orbital. And those carbon atom which undergoes sp hybridization, they have got less bond length and higher bond energy. So carbon-carbon triple bond, it is strongest bond with low bond length and higher bond energy.
So now we shall find the number of sigma and pi bonds in these two different molecules. So such type of questions will be asked in the exam. It's very, very important. This compound, it contains only carbon and hydrogen atoms. So carbon bonded to hydrogen, it is sigma bond. Carbon bonded to hydrogen is sigma bond. When you say CH, carbon is bonded to only one hydrogen atom, so it is one sigma bond. So when you say CH2, carbon is bonded to two hydrogen atoms, so two sigma bonds. CH3, carbon bonded to three hydrogen atoms, so three number of sigma bonds. And carbon double bond carbon, so in this case, you know, one is sigma bond and one is pi bond. It has one sigma and one pi bond. Carbon, triple bond carbon. One sigma and two pi bonds. This you need to know. Suppose if in the molecule, if halogen atom is present, if halogen atom is attached to the carbon atom, then that is also sigma bond. Carbon atom attached to halogen. So X, it may be Cl, Br, chlorine, bromine. X, it may be chlorine, bromine, iodine. So this is also sigma bond. Now what you have to do is, you just label these carbon atoms 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we shall find the number of sigma bonds between carbon and hydrogen. So first you write the type of bond, sigma. Below this sigma, that is a subscript, you write the bond between the two atoms. So I am going to write now carbon, bond between carbon and hydrogen, C dash H. So we shall count here, CH, so one sigma bond. Here it is carbon atom 3, CH 1, carbon atom 4, CH it is, so plus 1, carbon atom 5, CH 3, so 3 sigma bonds. Now on adding this, you get 6. Now we shall find the sigma bonds between carbon and carbon atom. So sigma, below that you write C dash C. So this equals, so between 1 and 2, 1, 2 and 3, 1, 3 and 4, 1, 4 and 5, 1. So total 4 carbon atoms. So number of carbon atoms 5. So in order to find the sigma bonds, you do minus 1. It will be 4. Now you add this. Take the total. Total, this equals 6 plus 4, 10 sigma bonds. Now you need to find the pi bonds. Right? So what you do? You write pi, type of bond. Below that as a subscript, you mention carbon, double bond, carbon. So C, double bond C. So it has got how much? When you say carbon, double bond, carbon, it has got one pi bond. Similarly, pi, C, triple bond, C. So, two number of pi bonds. On adding this, the total is 1 plus 2, it is 3. 3 pi bonds. So, the answer for this A organic compound is 10 sigma and 3 pi bonds are present. Now we shall solve this B molecule. So you label here, label the carbon atom 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? So first we shall find the sigma bond, sigma, carbon and hydrogen. So C dash H. When you say CH2, 2 sigma bond, so 2 plus, here there is no hydrogen, carbon 2 does not have hydrogen, carbon 3, it is CH, means 1 sigma bond, and carbon 4, CH3 it is, means 3 sigma bonds. So on adding this, you get 6. Now next, sigma C dash C, bond between the two carbon atoms. So this equals 1 and 2, carbon atom 1 and 2, 1, 2 and 3, 1, 3 and 4, 1. So total 3. So number of carbon atoms in this compound is 4. 4 minus 1, 3. Right? So now take the total of the sigma bonds. Total 6 plus 3 is 9. 9 sigma bonds. Now next 5-1. So 5, only triple bond is not here, only double bond is present here, right? So you write 5, below that you write carbon, double bond, carbon. So between carbon 1 and 2, double bond means 1-5 bond. Between carbon atom 2 and carbon atom 3, double bond it is, means 1-5 bond. So total 2-5 bonds. So the answer for this B molecule is 9 sigma and 2 pi bonds. So now, what is the type of hybridization of each carbon in the following compounds? So such type of questions will be asked in the exam, very very important. Now here what you need to know is, if the carbon atom is attached to all 4 number of sigma bonds, then carbon is sp3 hybridized. Means all 4 sigma bonds means no pi bonds. It is 0 pi bonds. Then this carbon atom is called sp3 hybridized. If carbon atom is attached to 3 sigma bonds and 1 pi bond, then that carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. If the carbon atom is attached to 2 sigma and 2 pi bonds, then the carbon atom is sp hybridized. Means I have written just the pi bonds here, I have not written sigma bonds. Right? You have to search for the pi bonds in the molecule, then your task will be easy. Now I will solve this first one. CH3Cl. See here, carbon is attached to 3 number of hydrogen atoms and 1 chlorine atom. Means all are sigma bonds here, no pi bonds. So this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. This carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. All 4 are sigma bonds here. Now next, B, CH3 twice CO. See here, 2 number of CH3 group is attached to CO group. So that means CH3 CO CH3. Now consider this CH3. So carbon attached to 3 hydrogen atoms and 1 another carbon atom. So all are sigma bonds, no pi bond here. So this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. Now what about this CO? Carbon atom attached to the oxygen. So CO, this is carbon is attached to oxygen by double bond. Carbon double bond O. So double bond is 1-5 bond. So this carbon atom is attached to, it has got 1-5 bond. Means the hybridization is sp2. This carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. Now this CH3, it will be same, sp3, right? So here, no need to see the number of the identical groups. The hybridization will remain same. Whatever the number below this bracket, no need to concentrate here in this, in the case of type of hybridization of the carbon atom. Okay. Now next, C. See, CH3CN. CH3CN. See this carbon atom, it is attached to 3 hydrogen atoms and 1 another carbon atom. So this is sp3 hybridized carbon atom. Now CN. CN. So carbon triple bond N. Between carbon and nitrogen there is triple bond. So when you say triple bond, how many pi bonds here? Two number of pi bonds. Means what is the hybridization of this carbon atom? If the carbon atom is attached to two number of pi bonds, then this carbon atom is sp hybridized. D H CO NH2. Concentrate on the carbon atom. Hydrogen, so CO. Carbon is double bonded to oxygen atom. Right? So one pi bond. This carbon atom is attached to one number of pi bond. So what should be the hybridization? The hybridization should be sp2 hybridization. Now next E. CH3. CH double bond. CH CN. How many carbon atoms are here? Four number of carbon atoms are there. Now we shall write the hybridization of each carbon atom. So carbon atom 1, CH3, C. So all are sigma bonds, no pi bond. Carbon atom is attached to three hydrogen atoms and one carbon atom. So no pi bonds. So this is sp3 hybridized. Now coming to this second carbon atom. So this second carbon atom, it has got double bond here, isn't it? It is attached to one number of double bond. Means it has got one pi bond. This carbon atom 2, it is attached to one number of pi bond. Means the hybridization of this carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. Now third carbon atom, same. It is attached to one number of double bond. Means it has got, it is attached to one pi bond. So this is also sp2 hybridized. Now the fourth carbon atom. So already I told you, when you say CN, carbon is triple bonded to nitrogen atom. So the hybridization of this carbon atom, it is sp hybridized. I include another molecule, FCO2, carbon dioxide. Now we shall find the hybridization of the carbon atom in the carbon dioxide. So here, now see here, this carbon atom, it is attached to two number of double bonds. It is attached to two number of double bonds. So one number of double bond, one pi bond. So when you say two number of double bonds, how many pi bonds? Two pi bonds. So what should be the hybridization of this carbon atom? It is sp hybridized. So the third question, write the state of hybridization of carbon in the following compounds and shapes of each of the molecules. First one, CH2 double bond O. See, this carbon atom is attached to oxygen by double bond. So carbon atom, it is attached to one pi bond. So this carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. Carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. The geometry of the molecule will be trigonal planar. Trigonal planar. Now next B1, CH3F. So this carbon atom is attached to all four sigma bonds, no pi bonds. So the hybridization of this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. sp3 hybridized. So if the carbon atom undergoes sp3 hybridization, then the shape is, geometry of the molecule is tetrahedral. Tetrahedral. See, HCN. See, here carbon is bonded to nitrogen here. So this is carbon triple bond N. So for triple bond, two number of pi bonds are present. So this carbon atom is sp hybridized. Sp hybridized. So the geometry of the molecule is linear. Geometry of the molecule is linear. So now we shall study some characteristic features of the pi bond. Under chemical bonding chapter, you have studied how sigma bond and pi bonds are formed. So now consider these two p orbitals present on the adjacent atom. So this is one atom and this is another atom. Now if the p orbitals, if they overlap in this way, this you call it as axial overlapping. So sigma bond is formed. This is very strong bond. Now if these p orbitals, if they overlap, so if this p orbitals, if they overlap sideways, then the bond formed is pi bond. So pi bond, this is a weak bond. Now we shall consider example ethene molecule. So CH2 double bond CH2. The condition for proper sideways overlap is the two p orbitals, they should be parallel to each other. So if these two p orbitals, they are parallel, then the proper sideways overlap takes place. So this is the model of ethene molecule. So black ball represents carbon atom and this white ball represents hydrogen atom. See, CH2 double bond CH2, right? See here, all these atoms, so total 6 atoms, they lie in the same plane. All the atoms, they lie in the same plane. See here, in this model I am going to show you the p orbitals present on the adjacent carbon atoms of ethene molecule. See how these two p orbitals are present here. They are parallel and they are mutually perpendicular to the plane of the molecule. See here. So this is the plane of the molecule and this p orbital, it is perpendicular. Right? So this rotation of carbon-carbon double bond, it is restricted. So we cannot, there is no free rotation here. See here, between carbon-carbon double bond, there is no free rotation. Whereas if you consider example of ethane, CH3, C2H6 ethane molecule. See, this is ethane molecule, CH3, single bond CH3. So you can, there is free rotation between carbon-carbon single bond. See the position of this pi bond. The electron cloud of the pi bond is present above and below the plane of this adjacent atoms. The electron cloud of the pi bond is present above and below the plane of this adjacent atoms in the molecule. Right? So the electrons, they are easily available to this attacking reagent. So those molecules which contain multiple bonds means carbon double bond, carbon or carbon triple bond, carbon. So molecules having double bond, triple bond. So for the molecules containing multiple bonds, the pi bond, they are the most reactive center in the molecule.
Ethene, it undergoes, the carbon atom undergoes sp2 hybridization. This diagram, it shows the formation of sigma bonds in ethene molecule, and this diagram, it shows the formation of pi bonds. So referring to this diagram, the green color, it represents the sp2 hybrid orbitals on each carbon atom, and the pink color, it represents 1s orbital of hydrogen atom. The three sp2 hybrid orbitals on each carbon atom, it overlaps axially with the two hydrogen atoms, that is 1s orbital, to form two number of carbon hydrogen sigma bonds. The sp2 hybrid orbital of one carbon atom overlaps axially with the sp2 hybrid orbital of another carbon atom to form carbon-carbon sigma bond. Now, with reference to this diagram, all the atoms, that is 2 carbon and 4 hydrogen atoms, they lie in a same plane. Now, these green orbitals, it represents the unhybridized orbitals on the adjacent carbon atoms. These unhybrid orbitals, they are parallel to each other and are mutually perpendicular to the plane of the molecule. These p orbitals, these unhybridized p orbitals, they overlap sideways to form the pi bond. Pi bond is weak bond, sigma bond is strong bond. In this diagram, you can see the electron charge cloud of the pi bond above and below the plane of this molecule.
So far we studied definition of organic chemistry, general introduction, tetravalence of carbon, shapes of under the shapes of organic compounds, some characteristic features of pi bonds, and problems related to find and the problems to find number of sigma and pi bonds, the type of hybridization of carbon in the compounds, and the shapes of molecules.